good afternoon. I don't often talk about the word here on this channel. That's not what this channel is for. This channel is absolutely 100% inspired by the Father and the Word. But I was told to come here and to give you the information as it was happening, not to give you an opinion, not to give you just mere thoughts, not to give you emotion, but to give you the actual data of what's going on. And we've been doing this since 2014, and I think we have set a pretty clear path for that. And you can go back, you're welcome to go back all the way from our very first episode all the way till now, and you will see that. You will absolutely see that. I think there are some misconceptions going on. I think there are individuals being misled, and my hope, and I firmly believe the Father's hope, is to try to clear some of that up. He has been weighing very heavy on me to make this video, because it's not, I'm not one that really likes to talk a whole lot about the Word, because, well, I don't remember the Word like a lot of individuals do, and you know, that might be the whole point. That might be exactly why he wants me to speak on it. So I have been questioned a few times for a statement that I have made, and I still stand behind, and I'm going to show you why. And I have said multiple times that those that are following the Father won't be basking in His glory and you know, living in the bountiful, if you will, the plentiful. Because, I mean, it's not hard to find, whether it be televangelists, you know, the Joel Osteens, or whether it be some YouTube channels that claim to be following Yeshua. Now, don't get hung up on the names. That was my first lesson from the Father, by the way. Not to be hung up on the names. I call him Yeshua. Many of you, and that may be an incorrect pronunciation, many of you would be used to calling him Jesus. And there is a lot of individuals that claim, well, maybe not a lot, but there's a fair amount, and there's a fair amount on YouTube that claim to be following Yeshua. But the truth of the matter is, they're following themselves, and they're following man. And I'm going to show you that. I've been asked a few times to explain this, because I don't think a lot of people make a click, you know, and I think that's partially because they're so used to the conventional churches, they're so used to the televangelists, and, you know, wow, you know, look at the blessings that's bestowed upon them. Now, I want to make a clear definition in between a believer and a follower. They're not the same. They're not even close. Now, I don't in any way, not for a second, want to make it seem like I'm stepping down on believers, because I'm not. But what's important to take away from this is that you can identify the believers from the from the followers, from the teachers. Okay? The reason why that is important is because if you follow a believer, you could very well be misled. But if you follow a follower, their heart's going to be in the right place. Yes, I do believe wholeheartedly that I am a follower. My life experiences have shown not only that I am a follower, but also shows what happens if you don't make good on your word with Him. Believe me, it's unbelievable. It is unbelievable. I will do my very best not to make the mistakes that I've made before. Because I don't want to disappoint him. And I sure the hell don't want to go through that anymore. So, let's go ahead and I don't have this all super prepared or anything like that because, you know, I don't think he wants me to. I think he wants me to speak to you, not speak from a script. See, that's, you know, one of the things that a lot of believers can recite scripture word for word right down the list. But the followers, they know what it means. Big difference. Big difference. Anybody can read a script. Not everybody can understand it. So I'm going to take you over. I've got a couple of web pages up. I am going to take you over. And because again, I don't remember this stuff word for word. It just is what it is. I mean, a part of me wishes I could. But then another part of me understands that maybe I'm not supposed to. Maybe I'm not supposed to. So, I want to start out, and I want to jump down here to this, to Luke 14. And this is going to be all ESV, English Standard Version. It is what it is. You'll still be able to get the gist of it, even if it may not be your preferred version of the Bible. But we're going to start out with this one here, Luke 14, 25 through 35. There's a big hint in this. It says, "Now great crowds accompanied him, and he turned and said to them, 'If anyone comes to me and does not hate his own father and mother and wife and children and brothers and sisters, yes, and even his own life, he cannot be my disciple.'" Huh. By the way, followers, disciples, same thing. So now, let's pick that apart. When you look out there, and you look at other individuals, whether it be televangelists, whether it be YouTubers, whatever, and you see those that claim to be followers, is that what you see? Those that does not hate their own mother and father and wife and children and brothers and sisters and even their own life? Huh. Interesting. Well, the good book right there says he cannot be my disciple. So how can you claim to be a follower and be living it up at the same time? I'm not going to call you a liar, but I will call you wrong. It says, "Whoever does not bear his own cross and come after me cannot be my disciple." Huh. "For which of you, desiring to build a tower, does not first sit down and count the cost, whether he has enough to complete it? Otherwise, when he has laid a foundation and is not able to finish, all who see it begin to mock him." Huh. So, let me get this straight. Those that are loved clearly can't be the followers. Must be those that are hated. Seems like we see that repeat in the good book in several places. This isn't the only one. We'll go ahead and we'll back up. And there's 46 Bible verses here. I've got another page that shows 100. I'll put a link to this page, the page that shows 100. And then I've got another page of things that I want to show you. So I hope I don't run you off. Please, there's going to be a message in here, I'm sure, for anybody that seeks the word, that seeks the truth. There will be messages in here for you. "So therefore, any one of you who does not renounce all that he has cannot be my disciple." Luke 14:33. So that means that, and I'm sure if you followed the good book closely, you know that the disciples were told that they had to give everything up and bear their cross and follow him. They didn't have all kinds of riches. They didn't have all kinds of stuff. They didn't sit there and promote. And it's called whoring. I mean, that's what it's called. It's just maybe in a little bit different context than what we may be used to. But that's what it is. My goodness. Kind of causes some confusion, doesn't it? When you look out there at the conventional churches and the YouTubers that claim to be followers. Believers, maybe. Followers, nah, got a way to go. For whoever would save his life will lose it. But whoever loses his life for my sake and the gospel will save it. Mark 8:35. So in other words, those that are truly following the Father will lose their life here, but in eternity will save it. It's right there. I'm not going to read all of them because I don't need to. I mean, how much more clear? And I just got started, right? Let's see. I mean, the major one is one that I have already covered. Right here, Matthew 6:19. Do not lay up for yourselves treasures on earth where moth and rust destroy and where thieves break in and steal. Boy, I guess maybe the Father didn't want some individuals to have another jet plane. It's crazy. It's crazy. Here we go. Luke 12:33. Sell your possessions and give to the needy. Provide yourselves with money bags that do not grow old, with a treasure in the heavens that does not fail, where no thief approaches and no moth destroys. You see, because in the end days, many people don't want the Father. They're not worried about his blessings or his approval or even his love. They want material things. They want earthly things. That's just the way it is. It's all in here. It's all in here. Watch the people closely that claim to be followers but don't fit the description. It's amazing. It's frustrating as well. I love the Father with all my heart. And every time somebody slaps him, it's like they're slapping me. It's very frustrating. Here we go. 2 Corinthians 8:9. For you know the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, that though he was rich, yet for your sake he became poor, so that you, by his poverty, might become rich. Interesting, huh? I'm telling you. And go on and on and on. Right here, there's 46 or 49? 46 Bible verses about giving up all to follow Jesus. And there's another one. Is it here? Yeah, 100 Bible verses, giving up everything to follow Jesus. Yeah. I'll include both of these links in the description if you would like to go over the entire list. But you know, I could sit here and I could talk about this for a very, very long time. But I do have another point to make. I don't want to make this too long. I think I think I put enough evidence on the table already. So, I want to point out, let me see where it is here. Here it is. James 3:1. It was staring right at me. Not many of you should become teachers, my brothers, for you know that we who teach will be judged with greater strictness. That's a fact. I can attest to that. Because I agreed. I agreed many, many years ago, long before I started a news show, I agreed to be a follower. And I reneged on that deal. I didn't do my part. And I was seeking sin, I was seeking lust, I was seeking money. I was seeking all kinds of material things. You know, and people might call, well, yeah, but you're trying to do this, you're trying to put this together, and well, yeah. Does it look like anything that we have is in excess at all? No, not even remotely. I've got two teeth in my head. I would love to get that fixed. I would do anything as long as it was in accordance to the Father's blessings to take care of that. But notice what I said. I could do things that weren't in his blessing and come up with the money to fix my teeth. But I'm not going to do it. Because I already learned once. When you're not working, being righteous, to earn those things, they will be taken away. I know. I had it happen. I lost everything, even a family. I don't know. Maybe some of these people forget. Maybe some of these people are con artists. It's not for me to judge. All I want is for you to be able to discern who you should follow. And I'm not saying you should follow me. Absolutely not. Because there are far, far better followers than myself. I'm still learning. I've got a long way to go. But I think I'm much on a better track than a lot of individuals that will get up there on the screen, whether it be a computer screen, TV screen, or what have you. And act like they own the word. Use the word as a form of control. Use the word as a form to excuse their whoring. I hope, maybe some of what I covered will help you set that path so that you could never be led astray. Shalom.